Want to show you how and why I added another linear rail to the x-axis of my Voron 0. My Voron 0 developed play in the x-axis linear rail and the print quality started to get a bit worse. So I replaced the rail with a new one and all was good till the play kind of crept back in again. Not sure exactly why this happened. Could be because I beefed up the cooling on the printhead with two 4010 fans. With a bit of extra weight, maybe the strain on the 7mm linear rail was too much. Anyway, I figured the cantilever forces on the linear rail were causing the problem. So I wondered, could I add another rail to spread the load? So after thinking of a few other options, you know, like switching to an MGN9 rail, or even redesigning the X-beam and printing an ABS, this is what I settled on. But first, let's get the bad news out of the way. With this mod, you lose about 7mm off the print area on the y-axis because the new rail clashes with the z-axis upright. I'm okay with this. It's the 120 by 100 still good for me on all the printing I do on this printer. And you're adding more weight to the moving parts of the X-beam, probably another 60 grams in total, but I don't print at crazy speeds and the extra stability outweighs the extra weight, so I figured I'd go for it. I'm running a modified printhead, so this change builds on the printhead I've posted on Printables. There's a link in the description. Once I figured out how to add the rail, only two parts needed changing. The rail carriage and create an extra spacer for the y-axis sensor. Fitting the new linear rail was the most challenging part, as you have to pull out the X-beam off the printer so you can insert the nut holder for the linear rail bolts to attach to. I did this by removing the carriage, unthreading the belts and detaching the X-beam from the wide linear rails. On reassembly, you have to undo one of the pulleys on either side to get enough slack and refit the belts. That's the worst bit. And then add the y-axis sensor spacer to the back of the X-beam and modify the printer.config bed size. And the result? The printhead feels way more stable. When you grab hold of it, there's no flex now. Unlike before, where you could actually feel flex in the printhead, now it's really rock solid. All the printing I've done so far looks really good. As you can see on these test cylinders, all the layers look really consistent, so I'm pretty happy with the change. Final thoughts? You could do this mod without losing bed space, but it'd be way more work. But at the end of the day, I think this is a simple solution for a really rigid and robust X-axis. Thanks for watching.